I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, I'm gonna let the reason out that his love goes on forever. I'm gonna take it all the way.
Welcome back to the Maple Minute this Tuesday, August 23rd, 2022. I'm Pastor Bill, and we've been discussing how to pray according to Jesus' teaching in Matthew chapter 6, part of the Sermon on the Mount. He gives us what we know as the model prayer, or often it's called the Lord's Prayer. And today we're going to talk about the topic of what kind of bread. You know, so often go to the store and we, my wife and I debate on what kind of bread is good bread, because I'm sort of picky about my bread. I love bread, but I'm picky about what kind I like. And, you know, this gets me thinking, especially when I read Matthew chapter 6 and verse 11, when Jesus says, "Give us today our daily bread." What kind of bread is Jesus talking about? And I think when we talk about this or read this, what it reminds us of is our daily need for Jesus Christ. Moses reminded the Israelites in the book of Deuteronomy that the reason God let Israel go hungry for a time before he provided them with manna was so that they might learn, according to Deuteronomy 8:3, that man does not live by bread alone, but every word that comes from the mouth of the Lord. Hey, that's the quote that Jesus used to defend off Satan in that first temptation of turning the stones into bread. You know, our daily need, or our need for daily physical sustenance, is a faint echo of our daily need for spiritual sustenance. And this was true for Israel, and it's true for Christ followers today. See, the only way that we will taste the goodness of God's provision is by living according to what God wants. And God designed us, God designed our physical needs to point out our deeper spiritual needs. That's the bottom line. It's the idea that our these physical needs really are a reality of the spiritual life that we should have. And not only that, is the only way we'll taste the goodness of God's provision is by living according to what comes from His mouth. So often we fail in our Christian life because we're trying to live by our own works, our own doing, our own religious, and even in good Christian circles, we create a list of rules and things we should do, but that doesn't always work. This is why Jesus helped us understand that we need what comes from the mouth of God. And Jesus referred to himself so often as the bread of life, the true manna that was sent from heaven, over in John chapter 6, as he's dealing with the crowd after the feeding of the 5,000. See, Jesus is God's ultimate provision for our spiritual lives. Just like we need bread every day or some kind of physical food, we need Jesus every day. See, each day as we pray for our daily bread, we should be reminded of, and we should recognize our deeper need for the bread of life, the only one who can truly satisfy our lives, that is Jesus. We should be reminded daily of our need for Christ to forgive us of our sins and empower us for obedience in following Him. And so I would encourage you, as you think about this, give us our daily bread. Don't just think about what I want as far as just physical needs. Think about what we really need, the deeper need. What kind of bread is it? The bread of life, as we finish this out. So let's think about some questions that will help us as we mull over what we talked about today. First of all, do you realize that your needs or desires or cravings are untainted by sin are actually from God? Sometimes I think we forget that, but did you realize that, and how do you respond to that? The follow-up question to that is, how does the idea that hunger for physical food should be a reminder of our need for spiritual food, how does that work in your life? It's so important that we see these needs that God gives us and not sort of push them off as something I shouldn't have, but realize sometimes they get tainted by our own sinful nature. But how does it work that we should be reminding ourselves about the spiritual food we need? Because I know so many Christians, they in their physical life they're plenty fed, but in their spiritual life they live on one sermon a week maybe, and maybe crack their Bible to read a verse or two. But most of the time they're anemic. They're so thin spiritually. They're anorexic, that's probably a better word, or they have so many spiritual issues. So how should this be in our lives? Then let's ask this one. Satan's first temptation of Jesus was turning stones into bread. If Satan was trying to twist Jesus' hunger into self selfish desires, what do you think Satan would do with your desires? And that's something we should analyze, because that's what exactly Satan was doing. And if so, why is it so important to see our needs and desires in light of our spiritual lives? See, we take our spiritual desires and needs and we sort of twist them in the wrong way. And then the only way of ultimately solving our needs or desires is by seeking what comes from the mouth of the Lord. What do you need when faced with needs or desires? And that would be such an important, what do you need when faced with these needs and desires?
I'm gonna praise Jesus' name, 'cause His love goes on forever. His love reaches to the heart.